and my mouth filled with praise. Is the heart of thanksgiving. I bless thee, O Lord. And with my hands together.
They are most bliss. As I sit there and I think about the question that Kelly was asked, my mind began to ponder, and I begin to look up definitions, and I'm a researcher, and I like to research different things. And it says, vision is an important necessity or quality of life.
Uh-huh.
The sensory, your eyes, is used to identify direction, character, and the importance of a content. Sight and vision are sometimes used interchangeable, yet they're different. See, you can see where you're going.
Uh-huh. Come on, preacher.
You can see where you're going, but be lost because you lack direction. I'm gonna say that again. You can see where you're going, but be lost because of the lack of direction. The lack of vision can cause weakness, blindness, miscarriage, deformation, and even death.
Yeah.
Follow me if you will. Vision, not sight, vision can cause weakness, blindness, miscarriage, deformation, and death. The eyes of the believer can become dim by worldly dust particles.
Yeah.
It becomes so dusty that everything around us looks the same. Now, let me give you some examples. Look at the church.
Amen.
It looks like the world.
All right. Amen.
Look at hate.
Uh-huh.
It looks like the new love.
Uh-huh. Amen. Preacher.
The hunger for lust.
Uh-huh.
Looks like the hunger for God.
Uh-huh. Amen.
Violence, greed, selfishness, and I can go on.
Yeah.
All identify the new fruits of the Spirit.
Amen. Preacher.
Dust particles. Worldly dust particles. Mm-hmm. Believers, where is our eyesight? Where is our vision? What are we looking at? So I pose this question to us today. How is your vision? Medical examiners, I know we all go to the doctor. Some of us even wear glasses. Our doctors recommend us getting our eyes checked every 2 years. And if you're diabetic or have other conditions, you're required to check your eyes once a year. Believers, how often do you get your eyes checked?
I see you preaching.
Are you really seeing vision? Or are you just having sight? Since we've lost our vision.
Yeah, Lord, that's good, preacher.
So, my second question to us today is, now that I'm blind by the worldly dust particles, how can I restore or regain my vision? How can I get back what God had given me when I first believed?
All right.
Because when he washed our eyes the first time, we saw men looking like trees. Then we went and got a donkey deal. I can see that. I can see clearly now that the dust particles, the rain, the storm is gone. The closet of sin has been opened. And I can see what God sees. So how do I restore my sight? How do I get that vision back? In Proverbs 29:18, this was a time where young Samuel, let me give y'all a little history. Young Samuel had been called for the people of Israel. At this particular time, he was talking with the Lord. He began to speak with the Lord in front of Eli. At this time, y'all, this was a time where the people of Israel had lost their vision. In fact, the Lord was scarce in that time. Can you imagine waking up in the morning and not seeing with your vision?
Hello.
the Lord's preparation for your life. Because he cares.
Thank you, God.
Because we just get up out of bed, rushing to get to work. We ain't said thank you, Lord.
Oh my God, show you right.
We just grab that biscuit and that orange juice, like spinning around, run out the door and beat it and drunk it and didn't say thank you, Lord.
All right.
We done ran the red light and I forgot what the car's coming.
Thank you.
But we done ran the light and didn't say thank you.
My.
We done got to the job, the elevator's gonna stop, but thank God there's a phone right there. I ain't got to climb 3 or 4 flights of stairs. I can clock it right there. I just say thank you. My boss that came in and she got a rough day, but she overlooked me and busted everybody around me and said, you go home, you have a good day, we're gonna get paid for the day. Didn't say thank you.
Didn't say thank you. God Almighty.
Go home and the house next to ours was on fire, but then nothing seized.
Come on, preacher.
We didn't say thank you.
All right.
Open the refrigerator door, there's food in the refrigerator, turn the TV and just somebody knows everything they have. We got food in the refrigerator, but we didn't say thank you.
All right.
Go to the bathroom and turn the water off so you can have a bubbling bath to wash all the work off of. Get in that water and relax, and the muscle relaxing. Get in that bed and then say,
thank you. All right, all right.
I know you're right.
All right,
that's good, preacher.
Look at that.
That's a good picture. That's a good picture, preacher.
Vision.
Yeah.
At this particular time, the Lord was scared, and the people were naked and open to danger. You ain't told God thank you all day. You done opened yourself up for danger. Because you lost your vision. Knowing who brought you this far.
All right.
When I think back over my life. I'm giving y'all time to think. When I think back over my life. And I see where he brought me from.
Yeah. Oh, yeah.
All the stuff that he done protect me from, and help me from, kept me all night long. The angels are watching over me all night long, and I wake up and.
Oh Lord, thank you. Oh Lord, thank you.
Covered. It's uncovered. You're in danger. Why? Because the people rebelled against God, and he exposed them to show the need of God's vision.
Right.
If you study a little further, you'll see that they received what they had been craving for.
Yes, yes, God.
They craved for a king.
Uh-huh.
Follow me, y'all. They craved for a king, and they got a king called Saul, and he had no vision.
Preacher, that's awesome.
In today's society, y'all, in today's time, we got all types of matter things going on around us, and people are searching for something.
Yeah.
Some are searching for glamour.
Uh-huh.
Some are searching for money.
Uh-huh.
Some are searching for that spouse. Some are searching for that special child.
Amen.
Where is God? Who's searching for God? Who's searching for God's vision for our lives? All right. So, if we look at vision, how do we restore and maintain our vision? There are three topics, three things I want to bring to you that I'm going to take my seat. The first one is, in order for me to get my vision, I must have faith.
Amen. Amen. Show you right.
Hebrews 11:1 says, now faith
is
the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not
seen. Come on, preacher.
Now faith is the substance of things hoped for and the evidence of things not
seen.
I know somebody knows words.
Yeah.
So you got to see it before you see it, or you never will see it. Before that vision got there, Pastor saw a vision of a building being there. Already furnished with the saints of God walking in, the remnant walking in, and then the newcomers walking in. And y'all that were sowing seeds like he said, and doing the things like he asked you to do, he saw the vision. I can't see, it ain't for you to see.
Preacher, come on.
But you got sight, he got vision.
All right.
He saw the vision because he's a man of God. I'm not saying he don't have vision, I'm talking about what he did. The vision.
Amen. That's good, preacher.
And if you are connected
yes, you will.
To the vision,
right.
You can see it too.
All right.
Stay connected to the vision, and you can see it too. Stay connected to God, and you can see God's vision.
All right.
Faith. In Matthew 7, 17 and 20, it says, how much faith you need?
Now,
you know, I was a country girl, just little bit girl, and I was, you know, into things. Mama days, I ain't dating no days, and how days know how busy I was. I never did go in the garden and pack no mustard seed, but I sure enjoyed the mustard green. Y'all ain't see it. I ain't seen it. But that one little bitty seed dropped in the ground.
What?
Planted down real good, watered, the sun, on that mustard seed, on that little mustard seed, started sprouting many leaves. Y'all gonna catch that in a minute. One small seed in the ground, connected to the sun and the water.
I see it.
Your own understanding. But in all things, trust him.
Uh-huh.
But I trust God more than I trust him with him.
All right.
And with him, I ain't boom goom. But I trust God.
All
right. And if I trust God, that means I'm going to trust the God in her.
All
right. I'm not going to trust with him. I'm going to trust the God in her.
That's all right.
It's all a right. difference. That's Y'all good. Catch the weekend.
Yeah. 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 Yeah.
So I'm believing in God's plan, and then I got to check my ID. I got to check the ID. Like I said, who did it? God
did
it. That's checking your ID. Every time something's going to happen, you know what? Who did it? God did it. My car is stopped. Who did this? God did, because guess what? He's trying to stop me from going down the street and get hurt.
Oh, no. Yeah.
Sometimes we think about bad things. Yeah. Oh, Lord, why does this got to happen? God is doing it for a reason. It's a reason for everything. Everything under the sun is a reason.
Yes, it is.
It's a time for everything. Ecclesiastes, it's a time for everything.
Thank you, God. Yeah.
And we have to give reverence to God in all things. Watch out, everybody. In all things. In all things.
Okay. Good preacher.
The preacher, you too. So in other words, y'all, if we give God the will,
yeah.
You'll catch this in a minute. If we give God the will, all
right.
We'll be in his will.
Yeah.
All right. We give God the will, we'll be in his will.
Because
right. You know, we don't give God the will, we out of control.
Yeah.
But if we give God the will, we're in self-control. Because God controls us.
Yes.
So when we give God the wheel and we sit back in the back, like I told y'all last time, get that back seat, roll that window down, get that windmill, let the Lord drive you on to destiny while you enjoy the luxuries of life.
Yeah.
Hallelujah.
Yeah.
So faith, y'all, is listening to God.
Yes,
Romans 10 and 17, so faith cometh by hearing, and hearing by the
word
of God. Belief is acting on what you know and or agree. Agreement. Amos 3 and 3 says, how can two walk together unless they agree? So how you gonna walk with God and you don't agree with nothing he say?
Y'all
look at the book, preacher. I can't tell y'all God gonna make a way, and I'm sitting up here doubting everything he do.
Come on, preacher.
I can't tell y'all he's a healer, and my toes start hurting. Oh, God.
Lord,
my toes, Jesus.
Oh,
God,
they
would
cut my toe off.
I don't even do it because they told me.
Preacher.
Woo.
I don't know. Preacher.
Start with the power on your knees, and you sit up there. You ain't got the pork chop that you really want. In the refrigerator.
Oh,
you got that bologna and some cheese and some bread.
Yeah, yeah.
But because it ain't the pork chop, you ain't got no food.
My Lord, preacher, a beautiful preacher.
Thank you, sir.
Oh, Lord, preacher, a beautiful preacher.
God said he'll supply all your needs. He said, I'm going to give you all you want. I'm going to give you your needs. This is nutrients right here. That bologna is your protein, and that bread is your carb, and that's enough to get you down the road. Because it ain't that pork chop with high blood pressure. I'm going to be out of nursing while I'm preaching, praise the Lord. God, give me your nutrition.
Yeah.
Give me what you need. So listening, faith is listening to God. Okay, so faith comes by hearing by the word of God. Belief is acting on what you agree on, Amos 3 and 3, walking together. The last one is trust in efforts to let go and let God. All
right.
And knowing that you're in God's hands. And it's all gone.
All
right. I did not say it's all good.
All right.
I said it's all gone.
All
right. Romans 8 and 28 says all things work together.
Yeah.
For them that love God.
And be called. Oh, Lord. Bless you, preacher. That's good preacher.
Isaiah 26:3-4 says, he'll keep us in perfect peace whose mind is stayed on him because you trust in him. A lot of times, y'all, when we're going through stuff, if we just start thinking on the peace of God,
yes,
the peace of God. In the time of trouble, the peace of God.
My Lord, thank you.
If y'all ever watch that tornado movie or know anything about tornadoes, there's peace right in the middle.
Yes, it is.
Of the storm.
It is.
Yeah. All the other stuff is around that peace.
Uh-huh.
So if you get yourself in the middle of the storm and have peace, you will come out of that thing. You will come out of that thing. God is our peace. Jesus is our peace. And we get to Him. We abide in Him. And Him and us, we will have that peace.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
To maintain vision, we must walk by faith and not by sight. Yeah, yeah. Trust in the Lord with all our might. Believe that He came to the earth to save, work miracles, show greater works that we shall do, die and declare He is great.
Yeah.
Come here.
And then rise with all power.
My.
Omnipotent. Omnipotent He is.
All right.
So now that you have the tools to regain or restore your vision.
Yeah, I see you, preacher. That's good.
Come on.
Bring home.
Come on, Holy Ghost. Come on.
That's what you bring home, preacher.
But without faith,
it's
impossible to please God.
All right. Preacher.
Without vision, it's impossible to see God.
Yeah. All right. Preacher.
Without direction,
look it up,
it's impossible to follow God. Without obedience, it's impossible to receive God. Without a relationship, it's impossible to know God. But with God, all things are possible. Vision is needed to see where you're going in God. Vision is needed to see where you're going in God. Now I see glory. Now I see my healing. Now I see my deliverance. Now I see the move of God. Now I got my direction. Now I got the obedience of God. Now I feel the relationship with God. Now I got the faith to walk in God. Now I got the faith to see God doing His majestic work in me. Thank you, God. I see Your presence. I see where we're going. We're going up and not down. We're going out and not underneath. We're going up to see where God is taking us. Even when you can't see Him, you got to know that He's working.
Yes, I do.
He is omnipotent, all powerful. He is omnipresent, and He's everywhere. At the same time, He's not with you and leave me by myself. He's everywhere at the same time. He's omniscient because He knows all things. Everything. There's nothing you can hide from God. And if you seek His face, and know that you're standing with Him, you will be led to destiny. Don't miss the move. Don't miss the move. God is moving in our presence right now. And if the dust particles are in your eyes, I dare you to see God's face so He can wash your eyes.
Yes, He will.
So He can cleanse your vision. So you can see not 2020. Not 2020. You can see God's vision of where He's taking you. May God have a blessing to those who have heard the word of God.
My Lord, my Lord, my Lord.
Amen and amen.
Bless you. Amen.
The door is open. I heard Him say, whosoever will, let him come.
Amen.
There's still room. And He'll watch the dust particles outside.
Come on.
Yeah,
man.
Y'all with me, y'all out here something again.
Yes, Lord. Amen.
Yes, you are with God. Amen. Awesome. The door is open. The door is open. The door. The door. The door. Not the doors, but the door. You say, I am the door. Behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man will open up, I'll come in and sup with him. He can sup with me. For God be saved. He's so gracious and kind. The door is open. Amen. If they don't want to come, thank you for the meeting.
I thank Joseph. My son was out there trying to sing. I'll praise God with the praise on. Amen. Come on, y'all. Put your hands together for the woman of God. Y'all. Oh, Lord. Thank you.
Yes,
amen. Dynamic woman of God. Amen.
Yes.
Amen. I thank God for God's word about being equally yoked.
Amen. I tell you what, I found a friend in Kevin Owens. Amen. Apostle. Amen. Amen. And I feel in my heart and that he loved me. Amen, somebody.
Amen.
And I believe that with all my heart. I really do. And I don't just say stuff to these people because I really don't.
Stop that, Joseph.
I'm past that point. But I really believe in my heart that he loved me. And you know why? Because he has shown that. And when you show that, you don't have to keep on saying it. Because you show it. Folks say it a lot, but they don't show it in the Bible. Don't put no action behind that thing. But he had to put action behind that. And not only that, once again, I'm grateful for them allowing me the opportunity to do that. And once again, amen. And she said it. We nothing but dust. Amen. At the end of the day, the dust particle have got everybody out.
Amen.
Can I tell the woman of God, I was blind at one time and could not see. And I thought I had 20/20 vision. But like she said, God go beyond 2020.
Yes.
God got something called perfect vision.
Yes.
Perfect vision. Amen.
Oh, yeah.
Amen. This woman of God did a dynamic message for God. Amen. Amen. For God's people. Amen. Yes. Everybody here that right now got a little speck in your eye.
Yes.
Amen. But he told the nephew, judge not. That you be not judged.
Yeah.
And then he said, ask him, why you worried about that little beam in mine? Amen. And both folks, they look at the beam that Pastor Arnold going on, and Mr. Arnold, they got a log in on that. Amen. Amen. I know I got some dust particles still working on. Amen, somebody. Because I know I'm saved, but I still got a sinner problem. And as long as I live here on this earth, I'm going to have a sinner problem. Because I'm going to be working with sinner people. Because anytime you're around sinful folks, you're going to have a sinful problem. Because you can live the best life you can, but some sinner problem will come up in your life. Sinner children. To the grandchildren, to the people, amen, somebody, and just to the people driving down the highway, amen. Once again, I want to thank this dynamic woman of God, amen, but not only that, but also showing the love that she has shown for this man of God and for this church, and I just say love ain't for this church, it's for this man of God, amen. We actually really have, we actually have